Artist Management for the Music Business, 4th edition, by Paul Allen, read by Christopher Ragland. Introduction. This book is intended to be the definitive guide to the student of management of artists in the music business, those artists who choose to manage their own careers, as well as to those seeking to become professional artist managers. Some of the tools developed for this book are found nowhere else, and active artist managers will find them to be helpful planning and organization tools. There are several templates available to download as PDFs with this audiobook, and they include the appendices at the end of the print book. In addition, the companion website for this book at www.artistmanagementonline.com is a continuing resource for both the artist manager and artists. The site includes a free directory of artist management firms, advice, and links to help the manager be a more effective manager in the music business. And most importantly, the website is the portal to an online course on artist management based upon this book. Music business veteran and professor at the Frost School of Music at the University of Miami, Christopher Palmer, developed the course with assistance from videographer John Grimson. It is an interactive multimedia experience with you as a student. You learn at your own pace. Visit the website for more information. Information from this book has been drawn from the experiences of many who work or who have worked as artist managers, as well as from the author's career managing people, assets, companies, organizations, projects, performers, and performances. My wish is that the words that follow will be your guide to a successful experience and career in the music business. Chapter 1. Professional Artist Management and Its Principles. Considering Artist Management as a Profession. Whatever your title, manager, personal manager, artist manager, music manager, brand manager, or representative, managing an artist in the music business means that you are becoming a part of every facet of someone else's life. As a self-managed artist, all of that goes without saying. There is virtually no aspect of the professional and personal corners of an artist's life that a manager doesn't encounter on a regular basis. Helping direct the career success of an artist requires significant involvement in their life. A manager who is new to the profession will find it to be immensely time-consuming and slow to deliver rewards, yet energizing with its fast pace and regular challenges. The music business swirls in its own continuous change. Before streaming became the primary earning source for the recording industry, managers were at the hub of the artist's career, providing many of the services formerly handled by labels. Labels have traditionally cornered the distribution of music, and still do, but online sales significantly reduce the need for a distribution system designed to deliver pallets of boxed physical product to warehouses. As traditional labels see their roles revived, they share a partnership with the artist manager with the goal of success for the artist in all aspects of their career. A career in artist management requires a continuing, almost daily, education by paying attention to what is happening in the music business and other industries and events that affect it, and what that means to the artists they manage. Artists in the music business are sometimes managed by attorneys, but there is a reason why professional managers are the best choice for artists to manage their careers. A top entertainment attorney once said over lunch that attorneys are not necessarily the best choices to provide career management to artists, primarily because of their conservative nature as practicing professionals. Lawyers are disposed to advise their clients on ways to conduct business without creating conflict. Today's artist manager, in order to stand as the strongest advocate possible for an artist in a highly competitive industry, must be able to push that advocacy to the limit, without overstepping the boundary of business ethics. Attorneys have become effective managers, but doing so generally requires that they step away from practicing law. Be creative, informed, and connected. Today's artist managers must be willing to encourage their artists to take calculated risks and then support their clients when they do. This doesn't mean they take chances with an artist's career. Rather, they involve the artist in promotional ideas that get the artists outside of their comfort zone and encourage them to be open to opportunities to help them reach their goals. While you're managing someone else's career, you also must manage your own. That means you must keep up to date on the entire music business. Certainly, technology and changes in the legal environment of the music business create new directions and challenges for artists, but they also provide opportunities. As a manager, you must be aware of trends and how they affect artists on your management roster. That means regularly reading publications and the websites for Billboard and Pollstar Pro, attending industry conventions, and subscribing to online industry headline services like those provided by Billboard.biz and AllAccess.com. Veteran artist manager Ken Cragen titled a book he co-wrote, Life is a Contact Sport. In it, he discusses the importance of developing and servicing a personal network of contacts. Being able to get that telephone call returned is among the most important assets an artist manager has. Without the connections, either direct or indirect, it is difficult to get business done on behalf of the artist. For the aspiring artist manager and self-managed artist, yesterday wasn't too soon to begin building that network. We'll have more on that later in this chapter. Understand people and business. Developing meaningful interpersonal relationships can be challenging, but it is more important for the artist manager than any other skill or talent. The work of an artist in the music business is a web of negotiated deals that requires the manager to have patience, an understanding of human nature, great communication skills, and a solid reputation of dependability. Each of these traits requires cultivation, but each will also become the foundation of a successful career in management. Aside from the music, business is the other constant in the career of an artist manager. As surely as music connects with an individual's passion, it doesn't become commercial until it's good for business. To conduct business on behalf of the artist manager must develop an understanding of team building, marketing, budgeting, and sales as they apply to the income streams available to the artist. There are frequent references in this book to a 360 deal, also known as a multiple rights recording contract. This term means that a company/label is entitled to a percentage of some or all of the income streams of an artist in the music business. It is most often applied to recording contracts that give labels part of the non-traditional earnings of new artists that they sign, such as part of their merchandise or ticket sales, in addition to profits from marketing their recorded music. Similar arrangements are part of some artist management contracts that provide the manager a small percentage of ownership in an artist's songwriting. As you listen to this book, you will see that the artist manager in today's music business is actually in the best position to direct, profit from, and control the 360 degrees of the artist's career. Let's begin with a look at the business and science of management. For the listener who is relatively new to management science, this chapter is the starting point. It puts the balance of this artist management book into the context of the basic principles of management. As you will see in the chapters that follow, managing an artist in the music industry, whether it is your own band or an artist, uses science, business, and a good measure of creativity to achieve success. This is especially true of the music business because of its nature as an industry that can offer high rewards for those who have a measure of success, where success is often measured by affluence. As we consider principles of management, it is important to understand that the goals of artist management are different from those of other areas of the music business. Record companies are in the business of marketing and selling recorded music and related products, and promoting online streams of the company's audio products. Traditional radio companies are in the business of building audiences to lease to advertisers. Advertisers then purchase spot advertising from the radio station that airs within the programming. Concert promoters present live entertainment experiences. Online streaming services like Pandora and Spotify sell access to massive song databases, and earnings from those subscriptions are shared with everyone associated with a recording. Artist managers are in the business of developing long-term careers for their artists, which includes touring, merchandising, sponsorships, licensing, recording, songwriting, and the full exploitation of all of their talents. Some artist management companies combine all of these functions for the artist under one umbrella. As we look at management principles, it is important to understand that the work of an artist manager in the music business is somewhat different from other kinds of managers. The traditional relationship a manager has with an employer is one that has a reporting hierarchy and by definition is very structured and corporate in nature. For example, a copywriter reports to a creative services manager who reports to the director of marketing, who reports to the VP of sales, who reports to the president. An artist manager only reports to the artist. Traditional managers use the resources of owners of a company to ultimately sell their goods or provide services for a profit, and in many ways, that is what the artist manager does. Much of the work of an artist manager is product development, sales and promotion, planning, and managing the work of the team around the artist. The relationship between the artist, employer, and the manager, employee, is considerably closer than that of typical managers in business, and is much more like a partnership. The level of trust and the strength of the relationship between the two are often compared to those found in successful marriages. This kind of association of a manager with an employer can also be found in politics, but is rarely found in the business world. However, there are times when an artist manager takes on most of the traditional roles of management, as he or she oversees the management of the artists as a brand, with the artist being a creator of art and entertainment experiences. Functions of management. Nearly every text, research paper, and discussion on the topic of management embraces four classic functions: planning, organizing, directing, and controlling. These functions all apply to the work of the artist manager in the music business. Planning. The difference between success and failure in any endeavor can often be tied to planning. Luck by itself can sometimes deliver success, but coupling it with a well-designed plan can put the manager in a position to take advantage of opportunities when they present themselves. It is very satisfying when opportunity opens a door to implement an active plan to take advantage of it. For example, a young Josh Groban was asked by award-winning producer David Foster to replace an ailing Andrea Bocelli in the 1999 Grammy television rehearsals with Celine Dion. His performance at the rehearsal was powerful enough to help launch his multi-platinum recording career as an artist. Groban's planning and preparation for a career as an artist put him in a position to benefit from the lucky timing of Foster's telephone call. 8 years later, he had the top-selling album in the U.S., and by 2017, the U.S. career sales of his recorded music were well over $250 million. When a leader or manager identifies worthy goals, he or she often collaborates with stakeholders, those who stand to profit or lose from an endeavor, to develop a set of logical steps to achieve them. Those steps, or plans, become the framework for successfully meeting goals. I credit Dr. Carter McNamara with saying, "Planning is identifying where you want to go, why you want to go there, how you will get there, what you need in order to get there, and how you will know if you're there or not." His ideas on planning in this simple sentence are the best guides you will find. His current website is a treasure trove about planning. It is easy to see why planning is often viewed as a roadmap that helps define the route to success. A career plan results from collaboration between the manager and the artist, which provides direction and milestones to reach goals. This book frequently addresses career planning essentials. Organizing. Organizing the manager's work is closely tied to the planning function. Organizing is assembling the necessary resources to carry out a plan and to put those resources into a logical order. It also involves defining the responsibilities of the artist team, hiring those people, and managing everyone's time for efficiency, especially the artists. The manager allocates the amount of time necessary to follow each step of a plan to get the intended results. The manager of any enterprise also seeks the funding or financing necessary to pay for the plan. The grandest example, long before the Great Recession, is Chrysler chairman Lee Iacocca's successful plan to pursue hundreds of millions of dollars in loans from the U.S. government in the late 1970s to save his ailing company from bankruptcy. It was a never-before solution he negotiated to save the company. The same creative initiative is often necessary for the artist manager on behalf of artists. For the artist manager, financing and funding the plan for a new artist's career could include a combination of an accelerated touring schedule, finding sponsors, relying on assistance from fans who offer financial help, asking for help from friends and family, and helping the artist secure loans. Managers also recruit and employ labor and expertise to put the plan into operation and to see it through to its success. The manager of an artist in the music business forecasts the need for members of the artist's team and plans for the time when their services will become an expense to the operating budget for the artist. The manager also draws any other necessary resources together, creates a logical structure for the organization of those resources, develops a career plan, and executes it. An artist looks to the manager to take the chaos of a prospective career and organize it into the prospect for success. Leading and directing. Managers provide a leadership function for the artist and their team by ensuring that the talents and energy of the team are directed toward the career success of the artist. The work of a manager in directing activities is to take the resources needed to reach goals and use them efficiently to achieve success. For example, an artist manager often hires a company or an employee to oversee the successful application of digital media strategies to the promotional plan for the artist's career. Promotion and marketing are elements of the overall career plan. This means the manager coordinates the energies of the professional team members working toward the artist's career goals, monitors income and the expenditure of funds, and plans and manages time. All of this work requires that the artist manager keeps everyone directed toward achieving the career plan objectives. Some of the team members chosen for the artist are on the active payroll, and others are used to support the plan on an as-needed basis. The term team, as applied to the group of professionals who support the artist, is indeed a group with a common goal, a successful career for the artist. However, it is rare that the team as a group will assemble for a meeting about the artist. Instead, the artist manager provides each with continuous communication about the activities of the artist and draws expertise or assistance from each member of the artist's support team as their help is needed. Members of the team communicate with each other as necessary. For example, the artist's booking agent forwards budgets and performance offers from promoters to the artist's manager, business manager, and perhaps accountant, and then waits for feedback. Controlling. Any manager who has created a plan follows its implementation by controlling all of the resources required to achieve the goals of the plan. When the resources, time, people, equipment, financing, have been assembled and the plan is underway, the manager monitors how effectively the plan is being carried out and makes any necessary adjustments in order to be efficient with the use of resources and to be effective in advancing the plan. The business of managing an artist in the competitive world of the music business means developing plans and an implementation strategy in an effort to control as much of the artist's developing career as possible. The manager must be realistic in what he or she feels able to control, but it also means that he or she must be flexible enough in encounters with reality to adjust to the circumstances. For example, a manager should anticipate that a new and promising artist will not be able to give a powerful performance at each audition and should be prepared to put the most positive spin on the result. Artist management skills. Networking is a key to success. Getting any career started, especially as a manager of an artist in the music business, requires a functioning network of contacts of people who you can do business with. Without that network, you truly don't have a path to any measure of success. You can't get phone calls or messages returned. People simply are not connecting with you, your career, or your management company. To build a network, a manager must be willing to become involved in both the business and the social sides of the music industry. An Austin, Texas restaurant posted this message on their outdoor sign. "I'm a social vegan. I avoid meat," spelled M-E-E-T. That amusing message resonates with more than half of those who listen to this chapter, as well as many students of the music business. The thought of entering a business social gathering and making new contacts is on par with a visit to your dentist. But whether you consider yourself an introvert or an extrovert, you will learn specific strategies in this section to develop the skills needed to build yourself a useful network as an artist manager or band manager. Long-lasting business relationships are built on FaceTime, not Facebook, and a few of those will turn into genuine friendships over time. There is nothing that replaces building meaningful relationships like eye contact and conversation do. It becomes very personal on that level. And if there is a meaningful reason to include that person in your network's contact list, it can become a lasting relationship. Seek out those opportunities to network at that level. Social media sites work well when the objective is to generally keep up with contacts and let them know about what you're doing, but they are no substitute for meetings and phone calls that build a business bond based on personal chemistry. From your author's perspective, my personal network has opened career opportunities in political management, the music business, academia, and becoming an author. Each of these opportunities came as a result from someone in my network contacting me about an opportunity. I've learned, and you will too, that networking is hard work. It doesn't just happen, but it could be the most important element of your own career development. Some career networking opportunities can actually become what Rachel Ginder refers to as shallow socializing and small talk. This is why you should be planning your networking time to be in the company of music industry people who you can bring into your network. Who are they? Among the first sources I suggest is a book that details over 100 U.S. colleges and universities that host courses and degrees in the music business, and likely one is near you. They often have networking events and conferences for students that you, perhaps as a potential student, could attend for networking. The Directory of Music Business Degrees by Dr. Richard Barnett on Amazon.com lists those degree programs. Conventions and seminars have price tags in the $400 to $700 range, but have some of the best opportunities to network. They include the Conclave in Minneapolis, the Music Biz Conferences for All Genres in Nashville, the Billboard Latin Music and Touring Conferences, the two annual National Association of Music Merchants, NAM, conventions, local songwriter associations in New York, LA, London, and Nashville, Canadian Music Week, the Canadian Urban Music Conference, the Canadian Country Music Association Convention and Awards, and the Country Radio Seminar in Nashville. As you begin your personal venture into music business networking, a good part of your development has to do with your mindset, the way you are looking at the idea of networking. This means, how are you planning to approach events and meeting people you should know? One of the first things to do is to truly believe that business networking is an opportunity for personal and professional growth. There is no risk, just opportunity. It's an effective way of viewing networking. I found that being social in the business world is very much like playing a role, and that role in that meeting for that moment is merely a business tool. You look around the room and everyone else is doing the same thing, even though they try to make it look like they're having fun. It is work, and it is part of the job of networking, bottom line. Not every artist or band manager enjoys social settings, but being a part of them and looking the part are the requirements of the job. Amy Cuddy offers her often quoted take on business networking. Don't fake it till you make it, fake it till you become it. She is saying to fool yourself, not others, in small increments to be in that moment and grow your comfort level with networking with each subsequent opportunity until it becomes part of your nature. By taking small steps, you actually grow into a comfortable place with music business networking. I was hired to become the producer for a 2,000-person annual music business seminar and convention for nearly 10 years, and seeing my first year's crowd of 2,000 guests at a cocktail reception gave me pause. I welcomed small groups gathered in parts of the room, but began greeting attendees who were standing by themselves. I introduced myself to a radio personality named John from a Western state who I had never met. He told me about his hassles at the airport Transport Security Administration screening because of the metal pins in his leg that resulted from an accident. We chatted briefly, and I thanked him for being at the event. He attended the convention for several years, and I thanked him for his attendance each time I saw him. He once said, "The reason I come to your events is because you made me feel welcome the first time you introduced yourself." Over the years, I had often faked it, but it was a nice feeling to know that also I had become it. When you meet someone for the first time, it's always comfortable to put the burden on them to open the conversation with standard things like, "How are you enjoying the event?" or "Tell me about the best part of your week so far," or "What are your takeaways from this event?" Putting them in the position of replying to an open-ended question gives you the opening to know what's important to them at the moment. Likewise, Keo Stark spoke at a TED conference and gave some good networking advice on what she refers to as triangulation. She says, "A strategy is triangulation. There's you, there's a stranger, there's some third thing that you both might see and comment on, like a piece of public art, or somebody preaching in the street, or somebody wearing funny clothes. Give it a try. Make a comment about that third thing and see if it starts a conversation." Nearly everything written about business networking covers the importance of listening, truly listening, to the individuals you're connecting with. This means a lot of things. Focus on the other person using good eye contact and don't let your eye stray over their shoulder, which sends the message that what they're saying isn't interesting to you. Let them talk so you can discover something you can use to continue the conversation. Avoid the temptation to begin planning what you will say next while they are still talking, and wait to talk about yourself until the moment seems right. Two things that can be overdone are exercises at remembering names and exchanging business cards at networking opportunities. I can always detect a novice networker when he or she mentions my name a half dozen times during a brief conversation. It is certainly a commonly suggested way to remember someone's name, and it is a sure sign someone is new at this, and perhaps at their career. Remember, you're playing a role in making impressions. Your success at networking meetings isn't scored by the number of new business cards you have collected. Your success is measured by the cards you've exchanged with people who have a purpose in your network. It is okay when you meet someone, invest a little time in conversation, and find that there isn't enough in common with them to go any further. That's when you reach for your phone, look at it, and say, "Look, I have to take this. It's really been nice talking with you." Dave Delaney points out, "Nobody likes the obnoxious guy at the networking event handing out business cards as quickly as a Las Vegas dealer." His advice in his book, New Business Networking, is not to use your card as a promotional tool during a conversation. Rather, he says, ask for a card from someone you've met only if it is truly a connection you want to make and remember. If the feeling is mutual, the other person will ask for your card. Of course, your card should have all of your pertinent contact information. Include only the social media sites that you regularly interact with. There are a couple of points about etiquette at business networking meetings that should be mentioned. The music business has a variety of settings for business social events, and how you should dress for them will depend on how others are dressed. Often, the event will be the current business casual, which the music business redefines every year or two. But other occasions require a bit more formal approach. Keep in mind that you're making some important first impressions. Another matter of etiquette specifically directed to men is always offer to shake hands with women that you meet. It's the world of the music business, not the genteel antebellum South. Be creative and aggressive in building a music business network because the relationships you develop are keys to your personal career success and to the success of your band, yourself as an artist, or your clients. In Chapter 4, we'll look at the effective ways to use social media networking to advance music business careers. An example of a starting place for someone new to artist management is to join an existing artist management firm as a junior associate, or to join as an assistant tour manager. You won't earn a lot of money, but you'll be exposed to those important people who need to be a part of your network. Drawing from the networking resources of an established management company is a convenient springboard for your own independent career. Other artist manager skills and traits. The other management skills discussed in this section are an indication of the breadth of the practical understanding of people and the music business required by an artist manager. For the prospective artist manager and new self-managed artist, these skills constitute a guide to learning. For the active manager, they are an affirmation of the truly special talents of management professionals who guide the careers of artists in the music business. Understanding human nature. Managing an artist's career requires interaction with people of all personality types and under many pleasant and some unpleasant circumstances. Studying why people react as they do to events in their lives is the best way for the prospective artist manager to learn. Members of bands who serve as the manager can have an especially big challenge because of differences in personalities and expectations, and the fact that human nature isn't the same for everyone. Among the most challenging can be those times when it is necessary to manage around the ego of another. The longtime manager of a platinum-selling, Grammy-winning group tells me of a time when one of the members refused to carry his bag from the airport, apparently expecting another band member to carry it. So the manager took it himself, rather than have an argument break out in the next band meeting. Because satisfying the needs and egos of a band that is also an artist requires so much work, many professional managers don't want groups as clients. And frequently, a band won't keep itself together long enough for a manager to exploit their talent, thus wasting the time the manager has invested in them. The music business is one in which egos thrive, with many trying to be somebody or trying to assert that they already are somebody, and often these very people can be the gatekeepers to the next step in the artist's career. Carefully playing into the ego in this circumstance is an effective way of using human nature to the manager's advantage. Before playing into a gatekeeper's ego, though, the manager will need to know enough about the individual and his or her ego drivers. That is, learning about the individual from your network or online search will give you some insight into his or her human nature. For example, if the manager is trying to recruit the services of a top publicist who is reluctant to take on an additional client, that conversation must include references to a specific artist's promotional campaign in which the publicist was a key component in that artist's success. Explain that you want nothing less for your client. The manager should also acknowledge any awards or special recognition the publicist has received resulting from their recent work. An understanding that personal achievement is important to professionals gives the manager an opportunity to service the gatekeeper's ego and open a conversation. Leadership. Leadership is an important skill or trait of an artist manager at the beginning of an artist's career or at the beginning of the relationship. The influence of an artist manager on the early planning and development of an artist's career is what helps the artist to develop a focus and an organized purpose. At this point, we are merely acknowledging the importance of leadership skills to help direct an artist's career, but we take a deeper look into both leadership and coaching and how they apply to a career in artist management in Chapter 14. Coaching. Coaching skills for the artist manager are closely related to those of leadership. Leadership seeks to guide the broader, long-term goals of the artist's career, but coaching involves short-term work toward an outcome that improves the artistry of the artist. For example, the manager coach helps the artist improve a competency, such as being able to develop more animation in his or her stage presence. Acquiring the skills of a coach requires that the artist manager study others who coach, regardless of the sport or profession, and draw from observed styles and techniques. Certainly, most managers will be unable to coach an artist in all of the creative and technical areas necessary, so it is important that the manager has a good network of specialists who might include vocal coaches, physical trainers, stage direction coaches, interview coaches, and more. Communication. Having good communication skills means the manager knows how to continuously connect using the other person's favorite methods, which are likely a combination of the written letter, email, tweets, instant and text messaging, telephone, fax, social networks, and every wireless device that will ever be invented. The manager will be interacting with all parts of the music business and must understand and be prepared to use those various communication tools. As an example of an industry sector that favors certain communication tools, radio promotion people who work for record labels or management companies depend on wireless devices to continuously communicate with their office and the radio stations in their region. Managers must also be advisors to their artists on which forms of communication they should use and how, when, and with whom they should use them. Each form of communication has its own protocol when used in the business setting, and the artist manager should be sensitive about when and how to use each. The late Sony music executive, Jack LaMire, for example, championed a universal voicemail courtesy that urges callers to office phones to leave their telephone number twice to prevent having to play a long message more than once to retrieve the number. Wireless phones display telephone numbers, but many office systems do not. If you don't know which type of device you are calling, leave your name and phone number twice. Email is another communication tool that sometimes takes on the loosely written style of a text message, but it is important to understand that email is a semi-formal medium of business communication that doesn't require smiley faces. As author of this book, I receive frequent emails from aspiring artists, and it is easy to tell from their email style which ones are prepared for the business of music and which are not. Other skills. Artist managers spend much of their time planning and organizing on behalf of their artists. Later chapters in this book describe in great detail the ways these skills are applied to the manager's work. The best managers also work creatively. The hugely competitive nature of the music business requires that managers must push their own creative skills to their limits in order to advocate on behalf of their clients. Simply doing what every other manager does is not enough to gain recognition for an artist's talents and potential. An example of using creativity on behalf of artists is a bold idea by Big Machine Records CEO Scott Bruschetta. Early in his career, his idea to attract attention for one of the artists he was promoting at an industry convention was to hire an entire high school band to march into Nashville's Wild Horse Saloon. He and his artist received considerable attention and left much of his competition saying, "Why didn't I think of that?" Fast forward to today. His creative skills now guide the career of one of the biggest stars on the planet, Taylor Swift. Artist managers are persistent. Persistence in this environment is defined as a quiet determination without being pushy. Remember that to be effective, the manager must navigate around gatekeepers, and an overly aggressive style can be offensive to some of those whose help is needed on behalf of the manager's artists. However, the manager who quietly waits for an email or for the telephone to ring has clients whose careers will never ignite. The best managers understand salesmanship and use those skills to create the interest of others in the music business in the manager's clients. Specifically, they are the chief advocates, promoters, and cheerleaders in the music business for their artists. Through salesmanship, they use persuasion to influence and motivate industry gatekeepers on behalf of their artists. Artist managers have a good sense of business and are good at budgeting the two resources that are not unlimited: time and money. Effective and efficient use of time can keep goals, strategies, and tactics on track. Planning the financial aspects of an artist's career assures that the necessary funding is available when it is needed to support the career plan. Artist managers have the necessary technical skills to deal with everyone from digital media planners to the sound technician at an artist's performance. It does not mean that they must be able to perform the tasks, but they must know enough about the technical aspects of the tools that support an artist's career to ensure they hire the best they can afford. Managers are also skilled at keeping themselves goal and results oriented. This means they keep their focus on the artist's career, and they keep the artist from being distracted by the frustrations that go along with pursuing a competitive, high-rewards career. Artists, too, must maintain a focus on goals, and it is the challenge of the manager to keep them motivated. Problem solving is one of those must-have tools for a career in artist management. This can include diffusing conflicts, resolving interpersonal issues, finding alternative ways to get results, and being the go-to person when major components of an event for the artist begin to fall apart. When confidence in every other possible solution is shaken, the manager must be prepared to take action and solve it. And almost as important as problem solving is the ability to find problems and deal with them before they become something to which people must react. Being a likable artist manager or band manager is a skill you can learn, regardless of any other feelings you have about yourself. Research by Dr. Travis Bradbury at UCLA found that the top adjectives for likability perceived by participants in a study were sincerity, transparency, and capacity for understanding another person. Among the key behaviors Bradbury and his researchers found that make people likable are: they ask questions. It shows that they're listening to what the other person is saying. They do not use their phones when with others. Enough said. They don't pass judgment. It means being open-minded, which makes you approachable and interesting to others. They smile. They greet people by name, and then use their name during the conversation. They leave a strong first impression. Bradbury says, first impressions are tied intimately to positive body language. Strong posture, a firm handshake, smiling, and opening your shoulders to the person you are talking to. Building a career in artist management. An artist manager grows in expertise in many of the ways managers in other industries do, and some approaches for growth are especially applicable to the work of someone in the music business. Here are a few such strategies that will help build a manager's position within the profession. 1. Give yourself a good self-assessment by looking at the strengths you have and how you will use those to your and your band's or client's best advantage. 2. In every circumstance, be professional. There is no better way to build and strengthen a reputation. 3. If you work within an artist management firm, do all you can for the success of the company, not just for your clients. 4. Build and maintain a network of contacts. That means calling on your contacts for assistance when you need it, but also offering help when they don't expect it. 5. Be sure the management firm you choose is a good match of styles, and be sure the artists you manage are a good fit with your personality and style. 6. Look for a mentor who can guide your development and be a sounding board for issues you face in management. The best mentors keep you out of the quicksand. 7. The smartest managers recognize that, for genuine growth, a career requires continuous education. Attend an occasional seminar or take an online course. Read relevant blogs and bookmark websites and podcasts that can keep you current in the music business. 8. Know the business etiquette for the music industry. 9. Be prepared for career setbacks and brace yourself for recovery. Not every project you're involved in is going to be successful. Know when it's time to cut your losses and then move on. 10. Keep an ongoing record of the things you achieve for yourself and for your clients, and document your public service work as a reminder to yourself where you contribute time. 11. Be a mentor to your eventual replacement, even though you and others think you are irreplaceable. 12. Be better than your competing artist managers and become known as an expert. And 13. Look successful even when your career is still a work in progress. Chapter 2. Preparing to manage. The short course on preparing to manage artists is this: get some education, get some experience, build a network, find some clients, and then go to work managing. This chapter includes details on some of those steps, but it also includes a deeper look into the realities of the business and the character of the necessary relationships that a manager develops in the industry. And most importantly, it will help managers understand the realities that have an impact on their effectiveness at advancing the careers of artist clients or their band. As you listen to this, keep in mind that most of the points made in this chapter apply to professional managers, as well as managers of their own bands and other DIY artists. The applicability of these points is merely a matter of scale or size of the managers' or artists' goals in the commercial music business. They all apply in their own ways. Management is part of a big business. Managing artists in the music business is done within the context of the general business environment, which is influenced every day by the economy, technology, politics, social and cultural factors, the price of energy, and international tension. Likewise, the practice of artist management is done within the environment of the music industry, which deals with issues such as illegal file sharing, market shares, fairness and royalties for intellectual property, the free use by terrestrial radio of copyrighted recordings, competition by other entertainment media, and rapidly advancing technology. For example, Chris Anderson's disputed idea of the long tail suggests to the music business that the industry is moving from being one that is hit-driven to one that serves countless niches of appetites for unique music. Anderson's theory is fueled by the speed of the development of technology and the speed of its adoption by consumers of music. Alternatively, Anita Elbers says in the August 2008 issue of Harvard Business Review that her research demonstrates that entertainment continues to be driven by music and motion pictures that are defined as hits that have broad appeal to consumers. Her 2013 book, Blockbusters, goes even further to say that having huge hits is the only way that a company can assure itself of long-term success. To underscore Elbers's point, an artist manager whose artist is also a songwriter and writes a song for someone else that sells 250,000 as single downloads and album cuts earns only $1,700. The songwriter earns $9,675 and the publisher earns $11,375. To some, collecting writer royalties for the sale of 250,000 copies of a song is a huge hit, but the reality is considerably different. And for many songwriters, online streaming is a disappointment. We'll look closer at how the math works for songwriting, as well as how streaming music online impacts artists who record their own songs in a later chapter. Agents and managers are responsible for connecting artists with career income, and both earn a percentage of the economic activity they generate for artists and for themselves. The range that an artist manager typically earns is 10 to 25% of the earnings of an artist, with the average being 15%. However, if no artists under contract with the manager are earning enough to cover their own expenses, the reality of when commissionable money flows as income to the artist can be a shock to new managers if they're not prepared for it. Recording royalties from large labels can be 2 years or more from the release date, assuming the album earns enough from artist royalties to pay back advances paid by the label to the artist. The sale of tickets to performances can be minimal to non-existent at first, but it can often become the quickest regular income source for self-managed bands and artists, as well as those with a personal manager. Earnings from publishing royalties can be impressive, but slow to develop if the artist is new to songwriting. So a new manager should be prepared to finance his or her own management business for 3 to 5 years. There are other ways to enter the business of being a professional artist manager, which are discussed in this chapter. Meanwhile, a more detailed analysis of a manager's compensation is presented in Chapter 6, where we examine the contract between the artist and the manager. Acquiring the knowledge. The aspiring artist manager needs a basic understanding of the entire music industry. Without it, the manager will never know about opportunities that he or she has missed on behalf of artist clients. Earning a degree in business is very useful, especially one that emphasizes marketing, brand management, and salesmanship. Earning a degree with an emphasis in the recording industry can give a graduate a very broad, contemporary look at the business that many active players in the industry do not have. A degree in law is helpful, as is a master's in business administration, although an undergraduate degree in business does give the manager a good general working vocabulary and understanding of the business world, which helps in effectively managing artists. Aside from the classroom, an especially effective way to acquire knowledge is to work for an artist management firm. Opportunities at management companies are limited, so a very basic entry-level position may be the best that is available, but the experience will permit the aspiring manager a place to develop a hands-on understanding of the artist management business and help build that important personal network of industry contacts. Another option is to seek an internship or apprenticeship with a management and production company that is willing to put the aspiring manager on the road for a season of touring. Many of the basic issues that a manager regularly handles come up on a tour, and one can get a good education about management issues by being in that environment. For the self-managed artist or group, finding a willing and committed mentor can save the manager a lot of time. The School of Hard Knocks is a great teacher, but most artists don't have the time to make the mistakes, learn from them, and recover from them. A mentor is someone who understands what the manager is trying to achieve because they have been there and done that. And the aspiring manager can learn a lot of shortcuts based on the mentor's experience in the music business. Understanding the nature of artist management. Any business is primarily providing a form of customer service to a target market, and artist managers must keep a good working definition of the customers that the artist serves. In other words, know your artist's customer, because music fans are not all the same. Certainly, the artist's fans who buy tickets, recordings, merchandise, streaming subscriptions, and digital products are first on the list. However, Others that artists and their managers serve include concert promoters, talent bookers, sponsors, members of the artist team, commercial radio and its programmers, playlist curators slash programmers of music streaming lists for companies like Apple Music and Spotify, print and digital media, and anyone else who relies on the artist to provide something. Striving to promote good relationships with people who rely on the artist creates the kind of reputation that draws and keeps the kinds of professionals who are willing to invest their energies in the success of the artist's career. Making decisions. Decision-making about an artist's career certainly has to do with business, but there are also decisions to be made that deal with art and artistry. As tough as some of those decisions are for the artist manager, management icon Lee Iacocca puts it best. If I had to sum up in a word what makes a good manager, I'd say decisiveness. Often, being decisive is easier to say than to do. For example, choosing the commercial viability of a single recording from a 10-cut album of music requires a certain intuition based on experience. In the music business, it often is referred to as making a decision based on your gut feeling, as well as analytics or data analysis. Former BMG Music Group CEO Clive Davis was said to have golden ears, because into his 80s, he continued to hear the sound of commercial musical success when choosing which artists to sign. Although Davis used a different part of his anatomy, it is the same concept as using your gut to guide your decisions. Artist management today requires professionals to step away from these standard strategies that have been used in the past to manage the careers of artists in the music business. Some things remain as they always have been. Some things like analytics are helpful, but there will be times when a manager must rely on that special inner feeling to direct the artist to an opportunity because it feels right, or to guide them away from it because it does not feel right. There are no criteria for this kind of guidance. You just follow your gut. Managing pressure. The stress that comes with managing an artist is set in motion when the manager begins promoting the artist's career. When launching a career for someone else, there is constant pressure to plan and to try alternatives that will work. On the other hand, when an artist has become popular, there are demands on his or her time that the manager must try to meet, because an artist's career in the music business has a limited shelf life, and there is an urgency to draw as much from it as possible while demand is there. Likewise, there is necessary pressure on the artist to present the strongest work ethic they've ever had. They must work as intensely as the manager does if the door is to remain open to opportunities. Artist management creates pressure for those whose style prefers order and predictability. Although an artist's manager is an advocate and is viewed as someone who makes things happen, managers cannot predict when and how often people will respond. That means the manager must always be prepared to react, regardless of the time of day.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.